All right. Merry Christmas, everybody. I'm just hanging out on Facebook for a little bit. Just going to do some imaging practice stuff. Some are some old analyses I know really well. A couple new ones I learned, and trying to see if it'd be something that's beneficial. So just doing a kind of compare and contrast with an old X-ray imaging set I have. Feel free to come by, say hi, hang out, or if you have a question about anything, I'm more than happy to ask. Philip, what's up, my man? John, I saw that comment. Yeah, something doesn't look right about my neck. This is because this is my first X-ray before I was under upper neck care. CT. Yeah, Rob. It's a ConeBeam CT. More and more chiropractors are starting to switch over to this form of imaging. There's a lot of benefit to it. For one, it's less radiation on the patient, which is good. And then you get a lot more bone detail. I was at a seminar a few months ago, and they said that the soft tissue, you kind of give up a good view of the soft tissue, but you're not really, when you take an X-ray, you're not really looking for soft tissue anyway. So I'm getting the best view of the bone and the joints I can see. And then just with the knowledge of anatomy, try to apply that and see if there'd be any potential stress to the areas, but mainly looking for bones and joints. Good. Ben, thanks for the like, man. And turned. Perfect. Looks like we are. Make these go away for just a second. Oops. James, Neil, thank you guys for the likes. Thank you. 7 roughly. That's fine. Math. Okay. That'd be 7.8. Yeah. Amy Wood, Renell Bays. Thank you both for the likes. Appreciate it. All right, that looks pretty good. I gotta bring these other measurements in now. Get our line back. This is off just a little bit. There we go, that looks better. That's what I should do. Okay. No, wait, I had it right. That's right. Take our measurements now. Blair analysis. Dr. Asby, yes, indeed. But we're gonna hop over to orthospinology analysis here in a second too. I learned how to do that the other day. And so I'm going to practice that in a second, just kind of fortify that. But I got a pre and post x-ray here. So we're going to do all the analyses on the pre right now. Then we're going to do all the analyses on the post. And we're just going to see and compare one side to the other. We are nerdy weirdos. I'm putting you on the top for that one. Oh, it's good to be weird. The future is weird, man. Set up right. Oh, that's a little off. Ooh. That blue one is off. Checking to make sure I have my pictures set up. So I'm digging off in other files really quick. Taken care of, so now we can take pictures. This out of the way. So I'm just gonna go ahead and delete that. I don't really need that line anymore. Where's that line? Oh, here we go. I think I need that for the orthospinology part too. I need that for orthospinology too. Oh wait, I gotta reset everything. Oops. There we go. Let's hop back to here. It's like my neck is like about to get thrown. It's not obvious what I have. Bad boy is riding up right there. Curve slicing picture here in a second. Thank you. focus on exploring. What's up, Morgan? You gorgeous man. How's the West Coast? Warm. That's the West Coast for you. You guys taking off for Christmas week, or are you guys open till Christmas Eve? Progressive warm. Subluxated, yeah, big time. This is my old ConeBeamCT. See a little bit of it right there. Open till Christmas Eve. Same here, my man. Leaving it open to get the last little wave in. I'm putting this on YouTube later, so if anybody's in the California area and needs an excellent chiropractor, Dr. Morgan Hurd is your man. Where's your clinic again, Morgan? I can't remember what city you guys are in. What's up, Carly? How are you doing? How's the way, way, way up north? Also, Carly, once I'm done with doing the both of these x-rays, I'm going to be posting it up on YouTube. So shout out to Carly Kapinski, too. If you're in the Anchorage area and need an excellent chiropractor, she is your gal. Anchorage, Alaska. And Morgan Hurd, yeah, if you're near Santa Barbara or and you need of a good chiropractor, head to Santa Barbara, California. Dr. Hurd will take great care of you. All right, what was I doing? Let's see here. I hate it when I lose my train of thought. Oh yeah, curve slicing. Go ahead and reset that. So much curvage. That should do good. Okay. Whoa, wrong way. Oops. Keep seeing moose, but me, I swear they're avoiding me. Oh, well, I hope you get to see one too. Are you sure it's not meese? Ooh, baby. Ow. See the outreach all the way over there. It's crazy, that was me. I see a little bit there too. But side. I think we all know what that left side is. Thank you. probably an anterior, but not really getting the best angle on that. I think it's moose. I'm thinking about putting cookies out, but we all know if you give a moose a cookie. What are you doing here? It's a great refresher. Yeah, feel free to stick around. If you have any questions, let me know. Just going through the Blair analysis, then you're going to go through this orthospinology analysis here in a second, and then we're going to hop over to the post x-ray and just kind of look at what changes happened. Is what the measurements say based on each. All right, so we got those angles. We got to hop back to the oblique slicing. All righty. All that wonderful work. We are going to flush down the drain now. This will probably be the best one to look at it. All right, say bye-bye. It's all gone. Okay, so I'm gonna make sure I did this orthospinology one right. Just disclaimer, I am proficient in Blair technique. I am not proficient in orthospinology technique, so any orthospinology people see me do something wrong, please call me out, but I would not go by me as far as doing this appropriately. The shout out Brian Asby too when he was here. He's a great upper cervical doc over in Dallas, Texas. If you're in that area and need a chiropractor, I know he's a solid guy. Spinology analysis. So I know we got to draw the dents first, and we want to make sure that that's lined up appropriately. So we'll go ahead and pull that up first. Actually, we got to do rotation first. So this one's an audible. The orthospinology people use different points for kind of determining rotation of the head. Ah, computer crashed. Hold on 1 second. Let's relaunch. Sometimes it does that when I switch around. All right, here we go. So when I switch between oblique slicing and curved slicing, I found that the program drops sometimes. It already has that drawn out for me, that's nice. Perfectly lined up. Good, good. Some screens around really quick. All so first step, we're going to draw a line on the top of the dens. Dens straight down. Doesn't have to be perfectly center, but all right, tip of dens, and then make sure it's lined up roughly with the ethmoid, but we'll see. Yeah, it looks pretty good. According to them, I'd be off a little bit. Based on them, so they got the ethmoid bone, and then you've got the I can't remember what it's called now. Let's try rotating it just a little bit. Forgetting my anatomy. Okay, so it looks like it's kind of lined up with the tooth a little bit better. Might have had a little too much rotation. Let's see how it looks now. Yeah, it looks a lot straighter. And then when you get down to the tooth, perfectly through the tooth. So, we'll use this line. Alright, so step one is to draw the S line. I think you want to try to take tilt out of it first, but double check. Yeah, you want to do tilt first. I'm squeezing in a little Blair analysis to look for tilt, because I can't remember what they do for tilt. You know, the points anyway, but I think they principally do the same thing. See what that looks like first. Mm-hmm. trying to get ready to draw the S line. And it looks like it evens out that atlas pretty good. Yeah. So you do that, you start seeing the ring. And then when we go back to just level, you kind of see the other side of the ring too. So looks like we have a pretty good tilt when trying to see the flat part of the ring. Again, not an orthospinologist or not proficient with it, so I'm going off what I read and the seminar I watched. This is the conundrum I have, because I can measure the right side or the left side. That'd be interesting, but let's make it a little bigger so we can see both, and we gotta go with So I'm not trying to draw out that point. It's just trying to capture this very small area. It's like a flat spot, but I think that's where it comes. I can't remember. it's where it like comes into the lateral mass right there. I think that's the spot, but I need to be sure. Disclaimer, this isn't a part of the technique I'm proficient in, this kind of measurement, but it's just practice and trying to learn it. S line. I don't have the graph to mark it S1 or 2 or anything like that, but that's pretty good. Just out of curiosity, I'm wondering what this measurement is. Interesting. Match up with the way I look at it. Alright, so with all that, we are ready to tilt this bad boy. There's a spot you want to wind up with. I don't remember it offhand right now, but we'll adjust that if we find the correction. What's the best way to see this? Give you guys a nice view. Alright, so let's go ahead and move up. And that's your nasium view. I think we want it to be a little ahead of the atlas, if I remember right. Be able to see anything then, but we'll readjust it as need be, but right now it's about lined up with the atlas. Okay, so we got the S line. I think the first step is to we want to find the inferior portion of where the TVP attaches to the lateral masses. Cheating when I do this a little bit. Again, not proficient in this part of the technique, but I'm just practicing so I can do double checks. This analysis has a lot of value to it. So I'm learning, I'm growing. I'd like to start using this analysis on every patient, but I gotta get it down first. Other apps. atlas plane line. So it's gonna be this one right here. Now I can cheat quite a bit to get the best view of this. So that's what I'm gonna do. Right there. It looks like right there. Have a double check you can do, so you can see where the TVP attaches to the lateral mass up top, and that's your double check line. But you're supposed to use the inferior one, so I'm just going to use the inferior one. So after you have that line, I think that's where we come up here, and this is where we start measuring the skull. I don't know if I have good suture picks on this one. Sagittal suture up here, you want to be able to see that and way above that, and so I don't really have a good, you know, way of really doing this. So yeah, to do this analysis, you got to get a good part of the skull to kind of see that whole orbit just meeting relative to the atlas bone right here. Let's get a better picture of that. So the atlas bone right here, you can think of the skull as like a big circle, kind of rotating left and right. Anatomically or biomechanically, it doesn't do that, but it's a way of measuring and trying to get the vector, the line going along the side right there right now. Trying to decide what would be the best way of trying to do measurements, because now I'm kind of getting on the alrighty. I'm gonna just pick a few spots. This is not the right way to do it. We're just going to try to work off asymmetry and see if we can kind of get this, what's it called, the center plane line, I think is what it's called. Yeah, I gotta look that up quick. Called the center plane line. No, it's called the central skull line. That's right, that's right. It's called the central skull line. About right there. Yeah, these lines aren't supposed to line up with the APL. We're essentially trying to figure out where the center of this whole orb is with this test. Spots.
All right.
I need my calculator. Arithmetic's not my strong point. Roughly 73. Oh. That line was 148.8 74.4. Come on, numbers. Come on. 73. Yeah, that's 73. Guess myself then. 5.9, 1.2. Yeah, that's fine. That's great. There we go. 74.4. Up. Okay, so then we're gonna draw. It looks like it's gonna be acute to the left, but we'll see. Yeah, that's about the middle of all three lines. So yeah, this is a left. According to this, we've got a left laterality. How do you write text on this screen? I don't think you can. So they're going to be adjusting on the left side. And funny enough, that's the side that I get adjusted on for Blair frequently too. I've been adjusted on the right side before for a misalignment, but my first upper cervical adjustment, they determined the left side was the primary, so that's interesting. All right, I took a picture, I think. Nothing without pictures. All right, so create lower angle dots. All right, so this is doing the lower angle, I think it's called. Yeah, so we keep the angle that we have, and we're gonna go down the, I can make this a little bit easier to see now. Alrighty. CC2 right there. Halfway point too, don't we? 49.1 divided by 2, 24.5. There we go. This is going to be really interesting. Where's my C7? I may not have C7 on this, but I'd be interested to. Count the lateral really quick. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, we only got, well, we might be able to catch the C7 superior facet edge. We'll just have to see what it looks like. This is one of my favorite ones. I do gotta mark the tip of C2. Yeah, I think we'll be able to do it. See, we got C6 right here, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then right below that we got the superior surface of 7 facet. So this should work just fine. Well, this would, I guess, technically be 6. I think you actually do the lower part of the facet now that I think about it. Somebody coming in, so I have to get off here in a minute. Okay, so 56.9. Okay.
Did I get that right?
Yeah, 28.5. Cool, cool, cool. And I have it the wrong color. So we'll connect the lines right there. The neural canal analysis, then. That's interesting. So, what's my angle? I don't think the angle. Yeah, the angle does matter. You want to measure that. So, it's an opposite angle, then, huh? Yep. There and right there. All right. Cool, cool, cool. So with this one and pre, I better take a picture before I forget. I don't know how to do the vertex analysis yet. I don't know if I want to do that yet. Tempted to incorporate like vertex analysis, but I mean, I just don't think, because we adjust differently, like we use a different kind of criteria. I don't think that would be useful. Maybe I could take it, but I just haven't learned that one yet. I'm just going to start with this because this tool I like as far as kind of seeing a better view of the neural canal and kind of like seeing like the way that's displaced. And it's interesting too that they use laterality to decide what side to adjust on. So based on this, I should be adjusted on the left side, but I mean, it's not major. Things seem down low pretty lined up too, but so what I'm getting from this is there's not a lot of strain on the cord. If I'm reading that right. Okay, stream. Well, I gotta take care of a couple things, but then I should be back on. I forgot what to do right here. They do something where like you draw a line right in the middle right there, I think. I forgot how to tell what to do. I'll have to review that, but I'll review that down the road. That should be an easy evaluation without a mark. I'll hop back on this afternoon and we will look at the post x-ray. We'll do the Blair analysis and then we'll do this nasium analysis too to see how the adjustment affected the whole spine. So sorry to cut you off there, but stay tuned. Oops, wrong button.